Today I'm going to show you how to make a pin cushion from scrap fabrics. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts, and today we're taking some of our scrap fabrics and some leftover charm squares and making an easy pin cushion. Now, what are you going to need? Well, you're going to need some scrap fabric, of course, so I'm looking at strips of fabric, such as these, and you want to make them thin enough that you're going to see several of them on the pin cushion because we are going to use a charm square. So there's often leftover charm squares when you're making projects, and if you've got one left over, that is perfect for the foundation that you're going to put these scrap pieces on. We're going to make a strip pieced block, if you will, to start with, and then I have a second charm square that I'm using for the backing. You're also going to need some polyfill or some type of stuffing as well. Hopefully I don't need that whole bag, but you will need some stuffing to put in it as well. I've also got that purple thang, which I'm going to use to help get that stuffing in there. And you're going to need a rotary cutter, your mat, ruler, those usual things. You'll probably need a pair of scissors as well. So the first thing I want to do is I want to go to the sewing machine. I'm going to take my scrap pieces of fabric, and I'm going to show you how to put them on this foundation to make that top for the pin cushion. So I've got my charm square I'm using for my foundation, and the first piece is going to go across like this, so on a diagonal. I got some selvage on here. I'm going to turn around the other way, which I'm not going to use at all, so I'm not worried about that, but just want to make sure your piece extends across at both ends on that first piece and it's right side up. Then I'm going to take a second piece. We'll take this green one, and I'm going to lay it down, matching the raw edges again, making sure it extends over there. And then I'm just going to sew it along with a quarter inch seam here to start. So there's the first one, first little set put together there. So I'm just going to kind of finger press it, and you can use, if you've got a seam roller, or even your iron, you can use. I'm using my Violet Craft seam roller just to press that down. I'll give it a press when they're all on there. And I'm just going to continue building out to one side and then build out to the other side using quarter inch seam. Don't overthink things like I do. Ah, let's try that one. Looks like that will work. So I'm just going to continue building this out, and then when I've covered the whole base, I'll show you what the next step is. I finished stitching all the strips here, and I'm just going to give it a quick press. I'm just spraying it with some of my easy press solution. So that's it for a second there. I did press them out with the Violet Craft seam roller, but I just want to get them nice and flat before I do anything else, because the next thing is we're going to cut them down to the size of that charm square. Nice and flat. Perfect. Let's put my iron behind me here. I don't need it anymore. All right, so here we have them, they're nice and flat. Now, a couple things I want to mention to you. So first off, you'll see that one of these strips is pieced. So if your strip isn't long enough, you can always piece a couple of strips, other pieces, I should say, together, two, three, whatever you need to get the length. And also you want to make sure that on the ends, you've got a good chunk of fabric here so that when the seams go in, that you're not going to lose too much off those fabrics. You'll notice there's a little bit of the foundation showing here. That's okay because the seam, the quarter inch seam, is going to take care of that, so I'm not concerned about that. So let's flip it over and we can see our square that we started with, our foundation, and we need to trim down all these extra little bits that are hanging off to the size of that foundation. And I can put those away for some crumb quilting if they're big enough, or they can be used for stuffing if they're small. So I'm just laying my ruler along the edge of that charm square, using that as my guide to cut. All right, so there's the big reveal. Oh, looks very pretty, nice and bright. So the next step is to take the backing, put it right side with the top of the pin cushion, and then we're going to sew around it, but we're going to leave an opening on one side to turn. So I'm just going to go to the sewing machine and sew that up and come back and show you what it looks like when the two pieces are actually together. So my front and my back are now stitched together, and I've left this opening along one side so that I can turn it right side out. Before I do that, I want to clip my corners close to, but hopefully not through the stitching. There we go. Now, this is the tricky part. I try and leave the smallest opening I can to get things out. And I've locked my stitches when I started and ended that stitching too, of course, so that I don't lose stitches when I do this type of a thing. Wouldn't work very well if I didn't lock my stitches. Okay, so we'll get this little guy out here. And that's where that purple thing can come in handy here to get these little corners out before I start doing any stuffing, which will be my next step. So I just have to carefully do this. That little guy out there as much as I can. There we go, that's better. Okay, so here we go. Here's what it looks like. And then, of course, I have to do some stuffing. So I'm just going to take little pieces of polyfill. So I don't take a big, huge piece and start stuffing it in. What I do is I take smaller pieces, I kind of roll them like this to compact them down a bit, and then I stuff them in, and I want to stuff them into one of the far corners and start stuffing like that. So that's what I do. I just keep adding small little pieces like that, maybe a little smaller than that. And I find that works better than trying to shove a whole big piece in and then you can't really get it exactly where you want. I also find this makes it a little smoother in the end product. So I'm just going to continue doing this, and I want to make sure I stuff it till it's really, really full, okay? Because it seems like over time that things shift around a little bit and it doesn't seem as firm. So I want it to be nice and firm, okay? If you wanted to, you could add some walnut shells to this if you want to do that with the polyfill or instead of the polyfill. You could certainly do that too. I prefer just to put polyfill in my pin cushion. So I'm going to keep stuffing away. I'll come back and show you what it looks like after it's been stuffed and after I've stitched the opening closed. So here's what the little pincushion looks like when it's all done. I think it looks really cute, and it's going to be decorative and practical in my studio. Now, you might be wondering what else you can make with your scrap fabrics. Don't worry, I've got you covered. Be sure to check out this video next because it's got all the information you're going to need. And for more helpful quilting information, make sure you go to my website at www.chatterboxquilts.com.